Good evening, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back to Hilaal Live. My name is Faraz Patel. I'd like to thank you, the viewer, for staying with us, and of course, my colleague Luqman Shadrack for taking us through that first part of the show. Now, this weekend, a Veterans League showdown looms as the ANC Veterans League holds its national conference to elect new leaders. Snooki Zikalala, who's the current chairperson, is seen as the favorite to win the post. Joining us now to discuss this is a member of the organization, Omry Makgoale. Mr. Makgoale, good evening, and thank you so much for joining us on Hilaal Live.
Good evening to Hilaal TV.
No, it's an absolute pleasure. Mr. Makgoale, I want to talk about this conference, of course. I mean, we've seen two different conferences prior to this, of course, the Youth League and just last week, the Women's League conference. I mean, just the importance of this conference as a whole, and of course, the necessity for the Veterans League to still be active within the African National Congress.
Yes, I think it's very important that the Veterans League are well organized so that they can be in a position to guide the ANC out of the current storm, you know, rescue it from where it is now. At the moment, the ANC is really sailing in deep waters, and it needs to be rescued. And only the veterans with experience of more than 40 years, you know, in the ANC, can manage to really to rescue it. So the main problems, of course, of ANC at the moment for all the conferences is accreditation problems. Mm. Everywhere it has been accreditation problems. But we hope that the Veterans League will be in a position when it's organized to actually restore the ANC back to its integrity, where it's supposed to be.
Mr. Makgoale, just yesterday, Snooki Zikalala, who of course the chairperson and really one of the favorites to be the president of the Veterans League, came out and said that the constitution needs to be amended so that rogue elements, and I'm just quoting what he said, rogue elements do not enter the ANC and, of course, filter it with corruption. Do you see this being a realistic goal with regards to the ANC as a whole?
Look, Comrade Snooki might have that wish, but as to whether you can clean the ANC of rogue elements at the moment, I doubt, you know, because you can't just patch people out of the ANC. ANC already at the moment is captured by some of the groups. They are inside the ANC. They are part of the ANC machinery. So it's not easy to, you can't patch them, you can't remove them, because who is holier in this circumstances? And this is why we have proposed that we should change the electoral law inside the ANC, how we elect leaders, so that the members collectively can clean the ANC through elections, because that's the only way we can clean the ANC without bloodshed, through elections. But besides that, other than that, I don't think you can remove so-called rogue elements in the ANC at the moment. Because you have to remove them, if you have to clean the ANC, you have to remove them constitutionally through reforms or through the methods that are acceptable without bloodshed. And I don't see it happening at the moment. But I think it can only happen when we reform the internal electoral laws.
Yesterday during the press conference, Susan Shabangu and, of course, Mr. Zikalala had stressed on one word, and I mean, this is a word that has been reiterated throughout basically all of the ANC conferences from the December right up until now, renewal. I mean, how important is renewal going to be after this weekend when that new leadership is elected for the Veterans League?
Yeah, it is important. We hope that the new leadership of the Veterans League will work towards renewing the ANC. And of course, the elections of this leadership will be a step maybe in the right direction, although it's not the best way of electing leaders, because the election method is still the old delegates method. So with the delegates, unfortunately, it's 2% of the delegates that actually attend ANC conferences. And so basically, majority of the veterans are actually not there at that conference. It's only the 2% that is there. And this is why ANC structures are captured by nefarious forces who've got money, and they bribe left, right, and center. But with the veterans, we hope they will not be bribed. we hope they are beyond reproach, you know, I would say.
Mr. Makgoale, the branches, of course, are going to play once again a huge role. But you mentioned, of course, the electoral system is for which leaders need to be elected in the ANC. I mean, during this conference and, of course, during many meetings which you are always part of, you know, how can that change? How can there be a system where not only is it efficient, but it has an inclusivity of all of the members to make their mark for the leadership that they would want?
Yeah, for that to happen, you know, we need to, ANC works according to resolutions from the branches, from the structures. The proposal for one ANC member, one vote for elected leaders has to be adopted by structures, branches, regions, and provinces. And once it's adopted, then it will now become a resolution that will be included in the ANC constitution. But at the moment, it has not been adopted. It has just been put on the table for consideration. The 55th conference of the ANC in December was supposed to consider it, but they did not maybe have time to consider it. So it's still on the table. But at the moment, with this method of branch delegates, very little will be achieved in terms of cleaning the ANC or rescuing the ANC. So, we hope that the Veterans League will make a move forward in that direction.
Mr. Makgoale, one final question. Whoever the leadership is coming out of this weekend, what is the priority for them, of course, in trying to make sure that the interests of the veterans within the party are looked after?
I think the key issue is that to make sure that the ANC is being cleaned, especially the question of corruption inside the ANC and in the state. The Veterans League must find way to make sure that the ANC is clean, the ANC and the state are clean. Because without cleaning the ANC, without cleaning the state, the possibility of ANC winning elections next year, especially in two provinces, KwaZulu-Natal and Gauteng, is in doubt. You know, is in doubt. So they have to clean the ANC and clean the state. And so maybe if they clean the help to clean the state, the help to clean the ANC, maybe we have a better chance next year of you know, winning elections in the normal way of winning elections. But for now, KZN and Gauteng are in the borderline. And unless we do something, we transform how we fight corruption inside the state, unless we clean up Eskom, Transnet, Dinel, post office, railway infrastructure running, unless we do that, these two provinces are in the borderline, according to my assessment.
Mr. Makgoale, thank you so much for joining us here on Hilaal Live.
Thank you very much for Hilaal TV.
No, it's an absolute pleasure. That's Omry Makgoale. He is an ANC Veteran League member. A conference, of course, happening this weekend for its new leadership. After the break, I'll be speaking to Quentin George. He's the CEO of Bosveld Mines. They are giving opportunities for illegal miners to earn a salary legally and, of course, mine legally. So do stay tuned to Hilaal Live for that conversation.